As we are speaking of Philippine Justice Secretary Remulla, he alleges that suspended prison's chief Gerald Bantag was digging for the fabled Yamashita War treasure at the excavation site in the National Penitentiary. Mike Navalio with the details.
It's 200 meters wide and 30 meters deep, almost equivalent to a 7 to 9 story high building. Yet the purpose for this excavation found inside the New Bilibid prison in Muntinlupa City has remained a mystery. Suspended Bureau of Corrections Director General Gerald Bantag said it's meant to be a deep swimming pool, he being an avid scuba diver. But that's not what he allegedly told Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla just this August or September.
Oh, by the way, no? That was supposed to be a treasure hunt for Yamashita treasure. Originally, I was told by Director General Bantag about it. And I told him to stop it. Ridiculous guy.
The Yamashita treasure is the alleged war loot stolen by the Japanese Imperial Army from Southeast Asia during World War II and supposedly hidden in caves and tunnels in the Philippines after their loss to the Americans. It was named after Japanese General Tomoyuki Yamashita. Many treasure hunters have tried looking for it over the years, but historians doubt its existence.
Ang bigat-bigat niyan eh, why of all country dadali ni Yamashita dito yan? Parang unlikely na dadali nila yan sa Pilipinas. Di ba dapat nearer to their territory? Ang daming mga treasure hunter, soldier of fortune na nagsisipunta dito at nagsususugal na mahanap yan.
Remulla is not aware if Bantag was able to recover any loot or when the digging started. He couldn't say for now what to do with the excavation.
Happened there. Tsaka saan nagpunta yung filling material? Kasi that's a lot of money.
Former Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara also denies knowledge of the treasure hunt. In a radio interview, Bantag said the digging was financed by the Agua Tierra Oro Mina Development Corporation or ATOM Corporation as part of its joint venture agreement with the Prisons Bureau. Under the agreement, 234 hectares of land in Nueva Ecija were to be donated by ATOM Corporation to house the New Bilibid prison, while the NBP reservation in Muntinlupa will become a business center jointly operated by the company and Bucor. 65% of the revenues will go to ATOM Corporation, while 35% will go to Bucor at no cost to the government. Remulla said the joint venture agreement is void because Bantag unilaterally decided to enter into the agreement, which supposedly goes beyond the build-operate-transfer law.
The joint venture was entered into by Bucor together with a private corporation without the permission of the DOJ. At that time, Secretary Guevara. So the president didn't go to that groundbreaking. I cannot accept that because, first of all, I do not want to privatize Bilibid.
Bantag's lawyer has declined to comment on the issue. Remulla said they will inform the Office of the Ombudsman of the illegal activities they discovered in Bilibid under Bantag's watch. Aside from contraband items, the new Bucor leadership found horses, a python, and other animals. But will Remulla ask President Bongbong Marcos for the removal of Bantag from his post, given the discoveries and his alleged involvement in the killings of radio commentator Percy Lapid and alleged middleman June Villamor?
When I have the chance, it's not very urgent to me right now. Because he's still under preventive suspension anyway. No? And that automatically gives him a hold or departure order because you cannot travel without a travel permit when you are a member of government.
Remulla also refused to answer Bantag's challenge for him to resign due to his supposed loss of moral ascendancy.
I won't even answer that. Name calling is the name of the game. No? Okay. I do not engage in that. I think at our level here, we do not do that.
Bantag is set to face the preliminary investigation for the murder complaints he is facing at the Department of Justice on November 23. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.